decimal addition and subtraction. For addition, whole numbers always have the decimal right after the ones place. For example, a 5 is the same thing as 5.0. So to add decimals, you line up the decimal and then fill in any zeros that you need to do. So let's try this problem. The decimal is after the 5. The decimal in the next number is between a 0 and a 3. The decimal here is 2.12, then 0.243. So we've got the decimals lined up. That means that I'm going to add the ones column to the ones column. The tenths are lined up. The hundredths and the thousandths are all lined up. So fill in zeros to make it a nice, neat, rectangular box, and then just add as you normally would. Decimal subtraction is the same way. You have to line up the tenths, hundredths, and so forth by lining up the decimal, then subtracting. So the example that we have here is 5 minus 0.343, or 343 thousandths. So I'm going to do 5 and line it up so that the decimal is in line with the decimal on the other number. Then we fill in our zeros, and we're going to subtract. And you notice for this one, you're going to have to borrow to get 4 and 657 thousandths.